Hello everyone. I will make for you next video, and on this video I show you some another project what I will make on summer, and this I call project, but this is a small book, actually four. Another small book, and I show you on this video it. But the previous I wanted to show you the first my another card what I will make, and this is you will see I used doily hat, I used my flower actually, and just because I used this Hello Kitty, so I will write hello on this. So maybe on this way you will see better. Light is not good on this camera. So this is the first, and when I will show you my summer fairy, someone write on comments that was great to make four fairy to one on the season. So I will make another. Another fairy, Autumn Queen fairy, but the first I wanted to tell that as made this fairy actually inspired me that comments the first. I will think is really was great to make for fairy, and I don't remember who writes these comments, but this is really great idea. The first person was Lori Richardson Heller. Lori made some doll from cardboard. Cardstock or cardboard, I don't remember. The second, Gina Arends. Gina made video to altered some playing card and made some embellishments. And Anne Williamson. And also altered playing card, but and made this on another way, just stamping on playing card, fussy card, coloring and glue on another card. So this is my fairy. How? Maybe on this way. Okay. So this is my fairy queen. Autumn fairy. So I play on this fairy just on this, not this, but this part. So all part of this fairy I will fussy cut from on this another side of playing card. You will don't see, but this all I will show you how is so what I will use, you will see, just because this is autumn fairy, autumn queen fairy, so I will use the leaves what sometimes ago send me Eileen McInnes. I will use you will see some smaller leaves and made like a fan. Maybe glue on the back of playing card and just fussy cut. And I will use doily, some doily. So my fairy queen of autumn queen have all colored color of autumn, yellow, orange, red and green. So this is it. And this is sad fairy, and I will, of course, I will make on December winter fairy. So this is it. And another just smaller, very smaller project what I show you. It's not exactly project, but I just try made the first time actually. Eileen McInnes made also made doll, just Japanese, how I call it, zombie doll, Japanese zombie girl doll. So this inspired me try made this scallop, and I also made this scallop with playing card. This is the first actually I will try, and I will made it. And this scallop have actually three time, this three part, this part biggest, this part smaller, and that part. So, by the way, I forgot to tell that the face of my fairy I fussy cut from playing card, like this. So just that you will see. And I on this part I will glue crown. So. And I connect this two part with brass. You will don't see, maybe not this small one and this second. And after I will glue on another playing card and fussy cut. So this I will try, and I like this way. So I will make another scallop. So this is it what I will make on some few day. And I will show you my another summer project. So this is small journal. Or small book, but I will go to another way. So the first I will cover it just cardboard and cover it to photo photo from some book, glossy photo from some book. This two piece was wallpaper. This flowers. Actually, I don't make these flowers, but I have some time ago, and just on some card to write. And I will use my some package on this and this. So this is different what I will make. This book was different what I will make to another my book. Why? Because on this book I will use brown paper, and I don't have now, but you will see I on between two page have this flip. So it was great to, for example, write on this page and glue on this flip something. So it's on every page. I don't show you because it's have on every page. So I connect this paper with some different way. So this is it. Just have two beads. Just because it's brown paper, so beads was like a brown. So this is the first. Another my book. It was this, and just because on this book I will use brown paper, so this is not exactly like this book. On this book I will use, I will make on this summer the first time coffee dye paper, and I will use I will make actually this paper on not like mostly people made. I used to make this paper instant coffee. So I will show you how I made. I will show you. Not on this video how I made, but what this what I will made the first, this I will made the second, and this I will made the third. So I will show you this. So this was also photo from book. Another photo I covered. Oh, you will don't see. Sorry. Photo from some book, another photo from that book I just glue, another photo from that book, and when I connect my signature from cover, I sewn these beads. And this, sometimes ago, this sent me Nancy Vastin, so I use this flower, is die cut flower. I use this flower on my book. Just brown, this how called, button. Photo. Another piece of that Nancy Vastin, an umbrella, and photo on this cover, washi tape, this washi tape. So like embellish to this book, I will use just only stamp. So this is V and star, heart of the corner, so used this way I will have, you will don't see great, I see that you will don't see, but this is very cool color have. Like a vintage color. No, you will don't see. Just because my camera recording on this way. And I don't have good light. On this moment. So this is the first. And I will to stamping, you will see I will use I wanted that stamp don't was different to page, so I will use vintage photo ink and literally vellum stain. So this what I will use to stamp it. So this is the first. Second. Cover. And this cover I will make with my handmade napkin paper. I will have video. Flower send me Lori Richards and Haley, glue doily and this card and also beads. Inside. And this rose, I hope you will see how, like this. This is one big photo. So I glue cover it inside of the of my cover and it was look great, I think. And two, I little hand sewing on this part and on this part and on this. And I will make some little envelope and put street tag on it. So this is also second washi tape. Washi tape, street tag another. This is another small coffee dye book. And on this book I will use only this one stamp. How? Only this one stamp on all page. So this is my second. My second small coffee dye book. And the last. This. So you will see have elastic, have flower, have two topic, right? And this is not craft piece, this is just some real industrial piece. I don't know from what, but I have this sometimes and I will use it and I connect to brush this. And beads and wallpaper. But this cover was literally different. sometimes ago I subscribe to channel. Just a second, I may. I must see. One guy online. And this crafter made a cover from kitchen tower, paper tower tubes. And this was a great idea. I don't have this moment I don't have on this moment this tubes, but it was long tubes, and I just this craft just fussy cut inside and fold like this. So this is, I will think that this is cool idea to use tubes, and I will make this cover. So this is it, and I used elastic some. This is my first flower two layers have, what I will made from brown paper. And this is also brown paper, I cover it inside. And from brown paper I will make this envelope, like library envelope, and this is to tag. Also coffee dye paper, just because this was coffee dye paper, so this tag I decided also made with coffee dye paper, and on this side was white, actually. On this side you will see like is different. So this is to tag on handmade library card. And I will use this flower, just stamping and fussy cut with envelope what sent me Josie Gito. And by the way, thank you again, Josie, and thank you again, Sylvia, for this die cuts and stamp. And this is just only die cuts paper. How? So I don't embellish on it anyone, and don't put any stamp. And on this moment I will make more coffee dye paper, and because that way what I will use is really how I want that you will see all of my what I will use is to me better and easily to make coffee dye paper that people made on mostly people made, because I will like drink coffee, you will know, but my mom drink instant coffee. So I will use. I don't like drink instant coffee, but I will use it. My mom don't know about it. If you want, I will show you on another video how I made this coffee dye paper. So, okay, on this video is all. 20, actually 5 minutes it was, is have. So this is not all my project. On next video I show you another my project. So to next video. Bye.